Hi friends, today we will see about oxygen administration and absorption atelectasis, the relation between them, which is very important. First of all, what is atelectasis? The term atelectasis is derived from Greek words ateles and ektasis, which means incomplete expansion. Here, the lung atelectasis means a complete or partial collapse of the lung or area of the lung. It occurs when the alveoli are collapsed or not expanding well. Next, the oxygen administration. That is everybody knows. Now, is there a relation between oxygen and atelectasis? Or is oxygen causes atelectasis? Yes, in some points. Oxygen can be a reason for atelectasis. How? Let me explain. The atmospheric air contains 21% of oxygen, 78% of nitrogen, and very small amount of other gases. So the air we breathe in is largely nitrogen. The human body does not use the nitrogen in any way, but the lung do absorb a small amount of nitrogen into the blood. So the partial pressure of the nitrogen in the lung matches the partial pressure of nitrogen in the blood all the time, because which is absorbed but not used. So when somebody is breathing room air, even if he is absorbing all the oxygen content from the alveoli, there will be still around 75% of air or nitrogen remains. Thus the alveoli cannot collapse. This effect is called nitrogen splinting. Therefore, if the patient is given 100% of oxygen even for few minutes, all the nitrogen content will wash out from the alveoli. Now, when after absorption of oxygen, nothing will remain there, and surfactant cannot alone stop the alveoli from collapsing or maintain patency. Once the alveoli is collapsed, it is relatively very hard to reinflate, and collapsing of one or more alveoli distort the architecture of surrounding alveoli, making them more prone to collapse as well. It is called absorption atelectasis. So before giving high flow oxygen or oxygen administration more than the required amount to the patient, we will get the patient condition even worse. Moreover, do not depend always on SpO2 and PO2 for oxygen administration dosage, because the SpO2 may be affected by peripheral vascular disease, hypothermia, peripheral edema, low cardiac output, and hypotension. PO2 in ABG may be affected by hemoglobin level, body temperature, age, smoking habits, etc. So for surgery patient, we have to compare the pre and post-operative ABG results so that we can set the baseline and maintain that baseline PO2 all the time if everything is okay with the minimum amount of oxygen. For other patients, we have to look for overall improvement and the condition of the patient with the minimum amount of oxygen. And the radiological studies can help us to rule out if there is any absorption atelectasis present, and we can manage that. I hope you enjoyed my class. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.